3 minutes this is for Tyson Fury.
Yeah, this is absolutely huge, isn't it?
Has he got to go for broke, Richie?
I think so. I think he's got to go for a knockout myself.
Here we go then. Nobody thought we'd get to this point. Nobody thought it would be like this. What can Tyson Fury do about it? Francis Ngannou's been brilliant.
The most unpredictable division in boxing, the heavyweight division. And yes, you're quite right. I don't think anybody in boxing expected this to go into the 10th round. Certainly not from the boxing side of it. The UFC maybe, but not the boxing side.
I don't think they thought it was going to last like this either, Richie, if they're honest. And I think we've taken unpredictability to new levels to this point here tonight.
Yes, I think most of your fans of UFC thought they probably had a good chance in those first three or four rounds, but not many of them would have expected him to go into the 10th round. Not with such the layoff that he's had, Francis Ngannou.
It's Francis that's been chanting around the arena. Tyson Fury still on the outside, still not committing himself in there. Ngannou controlling the centre of the ring.
And most of this contest, what's been interesting also, Fletch, he's boxed from the centre of the ring, he's kept Tyson Fury on the outside, he's made Tyson work on the outside, which has been really interesting and quite surprising there. But again, I think Tyson has played ball to a sense that he's expecting Francis Ngannou to come forward, but he hasn't been doing it. And again, sitting back, not coming forward much, is he, Ngannou? Just being patient with his work.
Well, he's boxed a very clever fight all the way through, Francis Ngannou. He doesn't look like a novice. He looks like a seasoned boxing professional in there against a man who's never been beaten as a professional in Tyson Fury. Widely regarded as the number one heavyweight on the planet, and he's got a minute to do something about it. Carl Frampton had him a mile behind after four rounds. Dan Hardy the same. I think Richie's pretty much on the same page as those two. And inside the final minute, what does Tyson Fury do?
Does he go for it, Fletch? Does he think he's ahead? I mean, you never know what's going through Tyson's mind, but surely he knows he hasn't performed well here. He's got to do something in this last round.
Ngannou left his feet to throw that one. He jumped at Tyson Fury.
That's a bit of the UFC. He's coming out of him there, literally taking off. Trying to launch a shot. We're going into the last 20 seconds now, Fletch.
Ngannou boxing as a southpaw. The big moment. The knockdown in the third round. That would have been a 10-8 round to Ngannou. Ngannou lands right at the end of the 10th. Well, there's the final bell. We're going to go to the scorecards, and who knows? The Ngannou corner is celebrating. They think he's won it.